Welcome back to AK TV. I'm your host, Gia Gold, and we are here at Istanbul Blockchain Week 2024 with the founder and CEO of MultiverseX, Mr. Beniamin Mincu. How are you doing, Mr. Beniamin?
Hello there. It's really great to be here and have this conversation. Thank you.
Is it your first time in Istanbul?
I think I've been several times, but definitely the first time for Istanbul Blockchain Week, and quite excited and curious to see how it unfolds.
Great. Where are you traveling from?
Right now from Romania, and we'll be traveling a bit in Turkey as well, just for some business discussions, but quite happy to see the energy here at Istanbul Blockchain Week.
That's awesome. Seems like you're very excited for your long trip and business trip as well. Have you tried any Turkish delights or food that you liked in Turkey?
I mean, there's a lot of sweet stuff. I love sweet stuff. And there's some pastries with cheese that are just very good to have every time I'm in Turkey. So love them as well.
So you seem like to be a sweet tooth.
You could say that.
All right, that's nice. So let's dive deep into your project. So Multiverse, why is decentralization important to you? And what is Multiverse doing to enhance decentralized infrastructure? Can you please tell us more about that?
Sure. So MultiverseX is at this point the most scalable, advanced and secure layer one in the world today. That is something extraordinary because it already scales beyond 100,000 transactions per second. And that's not in the future. That is all live and ready today. Now, having a layer one that scales like that, that becomes the most important decentralization value after you have scalability. If you don't have scalability, decentralization will not help you too much because you cannot use it for applications wherever you may use it. But the most important part is once you have scalability, then you can think about this truth machine and trust machine that will gradually be embedded everywhere in the world. And this is why it's crucial not only to have scalability first, but then also to be able to use it in real world settings to enhance trust and truth in all the world settings that we have right now.
That's pretty interesting. So you told me about this scalability. So how about the other aspects of the trilemma that you're trying to solve as well? Can you also explain how you solve, you know, those two other problems?
Sure. So the key point is that initially the trilemma was defined as you cannot have scalability, security, and decentralization all at the same time. But that was a kind of false hypothesis because it only is true if you have normal blockchains built that are processing everything in a serialized manner. So where every node processes every transaction and there's no sharding. The most important insight on which MultiverseX is built that changes the paradigm completely is this idea that wherever you may look in the world, whether in nature, society, or computation, we've learned one thing, and that is that you need parallelization in order to scale. Without parallelization, every blockchain today is dead. It cannot improve, it will not be able to add sharding, and unless it's built on sharding, it will face the scaling trilemma. Once you have sharding solved, then the trilemma is not present anymore because you have different parameters to build on and a different solution space to work with. So having this live and ready for years, but having it live today is extraordinary because it offers what Vitalik initially conceptualized, but they could not deliver at that point. We have that dream and it's live today, and that's MultiverseX in sort of one line.
That's a pretty cool concept that you just explained to us. How long have you been in mainnet?
Well, we built this for the last 6 years, and then we have 3 years since this is fully live working without any downtime, without any serious security issues, without any important issues that you've seen in all the other ecosystems. So again, it's extremely, extremely important to have this solution live, because initially this was considered impossible. It's one thing to have the hypothesis, to sort of have a white paper and discuss about it, and a completely different thing to have this monster that can not only scale the main MultiverseX chain, but as we'll discuss, it will also offer a kind of unification layer with acceleration and interoperability for all the other chains that have meaningful value propositions and communities within the world.
Great. So let's talk about sovereign chains. Can you please explain to us that concept and why is it so important in the blockchain?
100%. So sovereign chain take everything we've built for the last 5 or 6 years and create this separate one-click module that any builder within the blockchain space and any enterprise outside the blockchain space can use, leverage, deploy. What does it do for the blockchain space? Well, for the blockchain space, it just sets this new standard with a kind of unified experience, with a kind of state-of-the-art acceleration in terms of scalability and everything the chain can process, and interoperability, because the great part is that you can connect this to Bitcoin, to Ethereum, to Solana, or some of the other ecosystems. Because at the end of the day, if you build a kind of paradise island, the worst part is to have no one visit that island. The best part is to have it interconnected with all the important parts of the world, all the other neighboring islands and so forth. So this is what sovereign chains do. They're the unification layer that will spread around the blockchain space, interconnecting with the most relevant existing blockchains, offering a kind of acceleration layer for them, and then also interoperability between them in a native and secure way.
That's great. I love that you connected it with a paradise island. It made it easier for, you know, us, for the viewers to understand it better. So next question is, what specific advantages do sovereign chains offer to enterprises and governments looking to leverage the blockchain technology?
Well, the key point here is this. Enterprises look for one, either saving money or making more money. The key idea here is also that they don't want a module that's necessarily connected to a public blockchain that by default has everything public, where they can might share too many data, where other competitors can look into their data and so forth. What they want is a separate independent module that enables full customization, clear paths to use cases that they can use almost immediately with the benefits of having the best technology out there, state of the art in terms of scalability, privacy for data and everything they want to create, customizability for their particular use cases, and deployment within minutes. Like with a few clicks, you deploy all that and can use it almost immediately. That, I think, is something that is extraordinary, again, to have live today, not in the future. And the fact that you can have it completely disconnected from the public blockchain space is an advantage, but you can also decide to connect it just with the native interoperability module that is built in. So I do think that what we offer right now is what enterprises have always wished for, but they did not have. With sovereign chains, they can immediately access and use that.
That's awesome. It seems very seamless and convenient to use. And from what I researched a while ago, you guys also focus on being, you know, the green solution and has been recognized for having a carbon neutral footprint. Can you tell us more about that and why is it important for the company to also adapt that kind of concept?
Indeed. So I was mentioning that we currently have the most scalable layer one in the world. We have security and we have this advanced feature that enables interconnectivity with some of the other blockchains. Now, one important and crucial element is as things scale, to have something hyper efficient in terms of energy consumption and use, but then also to offset these costs such that everything we built is already green by default. Now, the two elements are this: we are already something like more than 10,000x more efficient in terms of energy consumption at the main layer one compared to Bitcoin and Ethereum. And the fact that we've bought carbon credits and so forth to offset the entire footprint that we had up until this point already puts us in a position where not only the efficiency of the main chain is great, but we're at the point where we've offset everything, we'll continue to offset everything in terms of carbon footprint that we have.
Wow, 10,000x. I love that. So we learned a lot about your project MultiverseX, but we want to learn more about you as well. So what is the daily routine of a CEO and founder of Multiverse? Can you walk us through, starting from morning to evening?
I mean, I'm probably very, very different just because at this point we have an extraordinary amount of things, projects and so forth within the ecosystem, within the broader MultiverseX network. And so I generally, let's say, work more than like 12, 14 hours a day. That's crazy. That puts us in a position where I take a look at the priorities in the morning, focus on them, get as much as possible done, and then probably have conversations with the different teams just in order to make sure that at the end of the day, we move some mountains and make sure that the progress is in the direction that we really need to get stuff done. The schedule is not fixed, is very productive in some sense, but then very tricky. If a normal person, I would say, would try something like this, it would definitely be extremely, extremely hardcore.
Definitely 12 hours. Wow. So you seem very articulate. So do you have any business book or personal development materials that shape your mindset that you can recommend me or our viewers right here?
I mean, probably a very, very good book that is useful in general to thinking about and differentiating between normal technologies, normal companies, and then technologies and companies where you try to build something that is fundamentally very difficult to build with completely new business models where most of the things have not been figured out yet and you have to have a very, very high tolerance to pain and risk and to be able to make decisions really quick is the book 0 to 1 by Peter Thiel. It's maybe if I were to state one insight, it's this idea that there is no simple recipe for just taking something and creating completely new technologies and new startups, but rather it's this idea of looking at the world with fresh eyes as to where the world is right now, seeing some insights that have not been seen, maybe have not been discovered up until this point. Making those discoveries and executing on them like there's no tomorrow. It's much easier said than done, but it's definitely worth pursuing.
I love that you mentioned about looking at this world with fresh eyes, because a lot of people, you know, when they wake up, they are very reactive. They're not proactive. And there's, you know, filters already that has been there. And they just go on with their lives, just doing as it is. But now that you mentioned this, this is going to inspire more viewers, you know, to dive deep into like, how is it like, you know, during your day and how is it like to be a CEO and founder? So thank you so much for sharing that. I have one last question, though, if you don't mind. If you can describe Istanbul Blockchain Week in one word, how can you describe it?
I'd say high energy. Not one word, but just captures a bit of the vibe here.
That's great. What's your plan for the rest of the day?
We'll be heading to the keynote in a few minutes, and then after that, probably some conversations around the event.
Awesome. Well, I hope you enjoy your keynote and have fun in Istanbul. Thank you so much for your time today.